Hello, I'm the Nostalgia Critic. I remember it so you don't have to. You know, I love the Looney Tunes. Who doesn't? They're funny, they're clever, they're unique, they're absolutely wonderful. And you wanna know what else? I love basketball. Again, who doesn't? It's fun, it's intense, it gives you a rush of energy, it's also absolutely wonderful. However, you want to be sure to keep these two elements as far away from each other as humanly possible. Because if you don't, you get fucking Space Jam! The worst piece of commercialized half-baked horseshit that ever hit the— Okay, alright, I apologize. I just really hate it when Hollywood takes not one, but two of the things that I hold so dear to me and poisons it with undiluted urine-filled backwash that I hate so much. So, with that said, let's take a look at how these two wonderful pastimes got transformed into the cinematic gang rape that lies before us. First of all, you might be wondering, how the hell did this idea even come about? Well, in the early 90s, Nike had a brilliant marketing plan for selling their hottest new item, Air Jordans. Obviously, they had Jordan on board, but they needed something else that would be sure to grab all the little kids' attention. So Nike made a deal with Warner Brothers to throw in characters like Bugs Bunny and Marvin the Martian into their commercials.
What'd you expect? Elmer Fudd?
The ads were a huge hit, and soon Bugs Bunny and Michael Jordan became America's top marketing whores, sucking dick for Nike, McDonald's, toy moguls, and too many t-shirt companies to count.
Gruesome, ain't it?
After this big success, the marketing heads at Warner Brothers got an idea. What if we turn the commercial into a movie, thereby turning the movie into a commercial, thereby producing commercials for commercials? It's like every advertiser's wet dream, a perpetual marketing money-making motion machine that has the ability to turn shit into gold!
Well, that's how it goes.
And thus, Space Jam was born, the first film that was quite literally a commercial for a commercial for a commercial. But don't worry, they hide that fact very cleverly.
Get your Hanes on, lace up your Nikes, grab your Wheaties and your Gatorade, and we'll pick up a Big Mac on the way to the ballpark.
Subtle. But still, a movie with two of America's most treasured icons was a pretty big deal, and we knew that the heads of Hollywood wouldn't just throw any crap together for their money-making prized possessions.
Obviously.
So tell us then, what's the story?
You see, these aliens come from outer space, and they want to make us slaves in their theme park, so we challenge them to a basketball game. But then they show up and they ain't so little, they're huge! We need to beat these guys, cause they're talking about slavery. They're gonna make us do stand-up comedy, the same jokes every night for all eternity. We're gonna be locked up like wild animals and then trotted out to perform for a bunch of lowbrow, bug-eyed, fat-headed, humor-challenged aliens!
Is it too late to get my money back? Okay, so the story Bugs was trying to get across starts off with Michael Jordan after he dropped out of the NBA. The first time he dropped out. We see him during those embarrassing years when he actually took up baseball instead of basketball. And that's not bad writing, that actually happened. Meanwhile, we travel to, outer space, where the evil ruler of a, theme park on the moon is looking for new attractions. So he sends his aliens to kidnap the Looney Tunes, who live in, the middle of the Earth, where the Looney Tunes retaliate by, challenging them to a basketball game. How many times have we heard that story?
We gotta get new agents. We're getting screwed.
But before we even get to that, we have to watch dozens of scenes where Michael Jordan is interacting with his family.
What's the matter with Jeff?
Well, he went 2 for 5 and lost 32 points in his batting average.
Is that all?
Yeah, so that puts him at like a 685 or something.
Oh, come on. Can't you get to the Looney Tunes already?
What do you think? I'm kind of partial to purple and gold myself. It goes better with my coloring.
Second thought, go back to the boring family.
What you cooking?
Chicken.
Chicken and what?
Chicken and collard greens.
Good.
And second thought, go back to the Looney Tunes.
One giant leap for Moron Mountain.
Is the 700 Club on?
I thought you'd never ask.
Judging by those clips, you may have noticed the first problem with this movie. The Looney Tunes aren't funny. They're rude, loud, and obnoxiously annoying, but they're certainly not funny. In fact, the writing for this movie is so horrible, you almost wish the original Looney Tunes from the 50s could sit there and watch it.
I'm a cheerleader.
But Mommy, I don't want to go to school today.
Boo.
Ah! I wet myself.
Very funny.
The second problem you may have noticed with this movie is that Michael Jordan is not funny. He's dull, boring, and an incredibly bad actor, but he's certainly not funny. In fact, I don't even think he knows he's in a movie. I think they just followed him around with cameras and then painted some cartoon characters in the background.
Suffering succotash!
Getting back to the story, the aliens decide to go back to our world and try to get some extra strength. While there, they sit next to the wife from Everybody Loves Raymond and the guy who did the voice for Homer Simpson. How random. So the aliens steal all the talent from some of basketball's greatest players.
We're fine. It's just some psychosomatic deal, or something to do with the moon or the alignment of the planet.
Wow, it looks like they took their acting talent too.
It stinks.
So the aliens become giant monsters which the Looney Tunes can't possibly defeat. So they get the help of Michael Jordan and his wormy little assistant played by Wayne Knight, who I was surprised to find out is not a cartoon character.
Oh yeah? Who says?
So the game is on, and all the Looney Tunes join forces to stop the evil aliens in a universal Space Jam. Which still sounds strange to me, I don't know. When I think of Space Jam, I think of that stuff they used in Spaceballs to block out the radar.
Raspberry.
So all your favorites are there for the lineup, including Bugs, Daffy, Porky, Taz, Elmer, Lola, Tweety, Marvin the- Wait a minute! Who the fuck is Lola? Oh, wait, I remember, from the classic Lola cartoons! You know, with the... and the... Who the fuck's Lola?! Lola, turns out, is a girl bunny they created to bring in more of the female demographic. Unfortunately, they didn't really make her fun, silly, goofy, or zany. In fact, they didn't give her any personality at all. They just tried to pose her off as some sort of strange sex symbol. Which is kinda weird, because she is, in fact, a rabbit. She's not a person, she's a rabbit. If it was a person, maybe it would make a little bit more sense to make her a sex symbol, but she is, in fact, a rabbit. Why would anyone want to fuck a rabbit? What sense does that make? Rabbits aren't sexy, rabbits are food! I mean, look at her. They dress her in skimpy clothes, they make her wear short shorts. Oh, and here's the biggest insult of all. They actually gave her bunny boobies. Bunny boobies! I mean, what kind of sick, twisted pervert actually gives a cartoon character bunny boobies? I mean, if that Hassenpfeffer hussy actually has female genitalia, what does that mean the other Looney Tunes characters have?
We've got balls!
Stop! Stop! Okay, alright. Let me make one thing perfectly clear to all you Warner Brothers representatives out there. We don't want to fuck bunnies! I can't believe I have to say this. We don't want to fuck bunnies! I mean, we're people! Therefore, we like to fuck other people! I'm sure there's some small percentage of people out there that like to fuck bunnies, but that hardly seems like a very profitable demographic! I mean, I put it to you, have you ever seen a bunny that you actually had the hots for? That doesn't count! Okay, so aside from promoting bestiality to kids, the film also has the worst camera shots in the entire world. That is to say, they're all extreme close-ups. Seriously, I feel like all the characters in this movie are about to French me. These shots are so close, I keep thinking the camera's gonna hit them in the face, like in the opening of Aladdin.
Too close, a little too close.
So all the Looney Tunes characters, Bugs, Daffy, Taz, Ho, and so forth, pretty much get their animated asses handed to them. And trust me when I say no one is spared. Dude, did they just beat the shit out of Granny? They did! They just beat the shit out of Granny! They actually tackled, punched, and kicked an innocent old lady who never harmed anyone in her life! Can I see it again? One more time. Oh my god, I could watch that forever. But unfortunately, the movie continues, and it turns out that Michael Jordan and his Looney Tunes are actually short one player. Who could they possibly get? Aw, no, Bill! What are you doing? You still got a career to lose!
Perhaps I could be of some assistance.
Go! Get out! There's still time! Look, you made it through larger than life, and you made it through the man who knew too little, but I just don't think you can survive this!
This is why I was born.
Okay, I'm gonna give you the name of a director here, Sofia Coppola. She's kind of a newcomer, but she has a lot of promise. Just think about it.
Very funny.
Of course it comes down to a tied game, and it's up to Michael Jordan to score the final point. But, in a stunning turn of events, they actually don't win. They lose the game, defining all cinematic conventions. Michael Jordan finds out that he is an imperfect human being, a fallen hero. He discovers the burden and responsibility that having such great power requires. But he also finds that strength comes from the mind and soul, and not just from athletic accomplishments. And though not the happiest ending, the film teaches children that even in their darkest moments, you can always find unity in yourself. And that, my friend, is the essence of ball on that guy. Nah, just kidding. He makes the basket and wins. So the Looney Tunes give Michael back home, give the players back their talent, and return to being their phenomenally unfunny selves. But Jordan still has one last thing to settle.
Man, you know he doesn't play basketball anymore.
You know, he probably doesn't even have it anymore, guys.
It's only one way to find out.
Welcome back, Michael Jordan!
Oh, I see. It's because of the Looney Tunes that Michael Jordan came back to basketball. God, this movie sucks! I mean, what were they thinking? In what insane asylum could this movie possibly be considered good? And you wanna know what the amazing thing is? This movie actually had four writers! Four writers! And not one of them knew that they were writing intergalactic pig shit! I mean, can you imagine what the writing session with these four morons was like?
I see aliens. I also see Michael Jordan being sucked down a golf hole to win a basketball game against Bugs Bunny.
Actually, that explains a lot.
That's it. We're out of here.
I'm the nostalgia critic. I remember it, so you don't have to.
God, what a bad movie!